public area, which I had my eye on in the summer, but the grass was way too long, so thought we'd give her a whirl today. Literally just come from there. I've got my first signal down here. It was 2 inches down. And I'm a pound better off. That's a good start. Alright, let's move on. Okay, I've come the pretty much the length of that path now. Had a few bits of lead. Just had a decent signal here. I don't know if you can see that. Looks like a 303 bullet casing. Okay. Okay, we're back in one of our usual haunts. That field was impossible. Grass was still way too long, so we're back in this wooded area, bit of a park, local area. I've just got my first coin. Hard to tell what it is just yet, but some unusual markings on it. I'll have to try and clean that up when I get in. I can see something on it, but I can't make out exactly what it is. Alright. Okay, next find. Well, four inches down, maybe. Very worn. Can't make anything out on it. No, can't see anything at the moment. Okay, let's move on. Okay, my next find. This could be exciting. If you can see. I think I found the ring. I have found the ring. I can see a pattern around the edge. I don't think it's a precious metal. I think it's copper or something. I can see where it started to. Sorry. I'll tell you what, let's put it down. Just see the green coming through there, but you can see it's definitely a ring. Like a band going round, you can see the design there. Oh, that's interesting. Could have been gold. You never know. Okay. Let's move on. Greetings, YouTubers. Cleaned up. Got a lot of interesting stuff, so let's move on. We'll start with the crapite. Don't know what that is, whether it was an earring or something, but you can see where it snapped. Don't know what that is. Not a clue. Some bits of lead. Chopped up coins. Two old half pences. So old pennies. Old one pences, I should say. And I've left these two out separate because I found this one on the surface, as you can tell, it's in much better condition. But I just want to check something out with you. Okay, this is a 1971, I found this on the surface. 1971, one pence. One zoom. Okay. And on the other side it says one new penny. But if you look at another, it says one penny. There's no word new in it. And I know that this other one's a 1971, the decimalisation was February 71, so this is one of the first out. But it's in great condition.
But yeah, I'm just wondering if there's anything significant about the rain, the wedding new on it. Probably not, but I just noticed it, so. Okay, two pences, and two £1 coins. I think I know what that is. That's a fuse cap or base cap out of a pineapple hand grenade. I'm pretty sure. It's got some writing on it, but can't make it out. 303 bullet, a bit of shrapnel. Two buttons. It's quite old, that one, I think. Well, you know, older than me. A little motor. This is in two halves, as you can see. But I was happy to find both halves. It's missing a few bits, like, but it's a vintage. You've got, if you could make that out, snuff. Singleton's snuff. What's that say on the bottom? Super menthol. I can't imagine it's too old. Singleton and Cole, Birmingham, England. Interesting. Okay, here's the ring I found. That design that was going around, it's either, or what I thought was a design, it turns out to be cotton. See if I can pull it off. So obviously someone's had that. That's how they come to lose it. They've had cotton wrapped around it because it was too small or too big for them. But I think it's bronze or something, so it was a ring though. Someone wore it as a ring, you can tell by the shape. Okay. And 3 decimals. Okay. You probably won't be able to get any off that. There's George the Fifth. That's knackered, that one. This one. I don't even know if that's a coin, I can't get anything on it at all. And that red underneath makes me suspicious. This thing. Let's just put that down a minute, because it's got like a leaf going around the edge. You see going up the left and up the right, I don't know if you can see that properly, but I'll get some close-ups, some macros of that. That's quite interesting, that one. Okay. Believe it or not, this is a widow head, a veiled head. Victoria, you can just see it there. Absolutely knackered. Elizabeth II, chopped in half. Elizabeth II penny, 1962. One more, I got it. George VI, ship ain't me. I think that's 1945, you know. And you see the veiled head. Vicky, I think it was a halfpenny that, you know, but all the edges are really crusty. It's falling apart in my hands. And give me a little bit of silver for the day. Barely silver, 1945, sixpence. So six. To give a really dodgy signal on the Garrett. Comes up as a 1 cent on the Garrett 250. So we were in public park today, so we were in digging everything we hit, you know, all the belt homes. We were just digging the positive ones. And this was one of the very last signals I got, and I wouldn't have bothered digging it, but it was 2 inches, so I thought, well, it might be a 10p or something. And turned out to be that. Very surprised. But, you know, it's a bit of silver, and I'm happy with that. It's nice to come away with a bit of silver at the end of the day. Okay, folks. That's it for now. Until next time, happy hunting. Catch you again.